Hey guys, welcome back, it is Jafmasterflash. How are you all doing today? And welcome to round 5 of ERN. We are at Zandvoort in the Netherlands for this week's league race. As you can see, this is my final run out of qualifying. It was wet, it did start off wet. Went out, set a lap, got me to P3, and then as the track started to dry out, as you can see, I'm way in P6 at the moment, but I'm on my final run. I left it as long as I could because the track was drying out and I was kind of needed about another 4 or 5 minutes to make it out on the softs. But yeah, I didn't get that time, so I had to make the best of a bad situation on the inters and go out. At this point, before I went out, there was about four plus seconds left on the inters, where I needed it to be obviously a lot quicker than it was. Down in sector 2, but sector 2 was my was the area where I was gaining more time rather than losing it, but I don't understand how I was down. But I'm coming into the last but one turn, and as you can see, I've gained nearly 2/10. Lost a bit going into the final turn, and then started gaining a little bit back, and then lost a little bit. But this was, I managed to gain 2/10. I did finish P3. I did qualify P3, but there was a car in front who had a grid penalty. I overfilled the car. I didn't expect there to be much action. As you can see, I'm in a party with Alice. Obviously, I know Alice. I've raced a lot with Alice, and you'll know Alice from all the videos that I do. But unbeknownst to me, me and Alice was talking strategy before the race, and Alice was going to go on to the soft and then hard, but after having a discussion, convinced him to do the same strategy as me, and fair play, he managed to get it to work, no problem. I didn't know though that he had underfueled his car, which made him very, very quick. As you can see, Jamie, the G, my teammate, he's right behind me. He's right on my tail, and fair play to him. We didn't even make the first lap, and the VSC is out. It's kind of hard when you're on the hard tyres to try and get heat into them, and then when you have to slow down almost straight away, it's even harder. But Ellis is quickly hunting down Wispy, and everything seemed good. Everything seemed great. I went way too deep in there, and then that let ERN recoil take the shot and take a stab, and especially on those medium tyres, recoil is unbelievably quick, and trying to track him down is going to be difficult. My car was set up to handle Sector 2 better than Sector 1 and Sector 3, because I found I struggled a lot harder and a lot more in Sector 2. Rather than sector 1 and sector 3. However, looking back at the race, I should have been more clinical, and I took too long to get going. As you can see, it's lap 2 and I've allowed recoil to almost get past me, you know, and get out of the DRS, when really I should have been right at the back of recoil. I know I had the pace, I really did. Took my foot off the gas a little bit too much, I would have thought. As you can see, Alice is 1.8 in front, and I shouldn't have let it get that far. But I was thinking, I had plenty of time to catch back, to catch up and whatnot. And I was kind of hoping that laps 15 onwards, when the hard started to die off, I knew that I still would have good pace in them. As I enjoy the hard tyres around here, and then I'm just going to go as deep as I could into the race, and then switch to the softs, and then go for it, hammer and nails. Unfortunately, strategies don't always pay off in league racing. Things happen and you have to change and adapt quickly. Unfortunately, I think today I adapted to the wrong kind of change. I expected a lot of tyre wear, and believe it or not, the tyre wear didn't happen as much as I thought it would. whereas I picked the wrong tire in the end, but I'll let you guys get to that point and watch that. All in all, it was a really good race. I enjoyed the race. I enjoy racing, you know, with these guys. I really, really do. Unfortunately, I just allowed everybody to get away from me far too easily. I really, really did. Next up, we are at Spain, and I think after this race, yeah, it's definitely opened my eyes, should I say, and I need to be a lot more ruthless and clinical, and not take too long to get into the race. I need to hit the ground running, kind of thing. But yeah, nevertheless, hope you guys enjoy Zandvoort as much as I do. I really do. This is becoming a really fun, a really awesome circuit for me, and one I really enjoy. Just looking forward to seeing real F1 cars go around here. But yeah, it was a good race, and you know, like I said, I've known Alice for a long, long time now, and he's a good kid, and yeah, massive congratulations to him, and because he was a reserve in the league, and now he secured himself a full-time seat, and I think he was rewarded with that full-time seat today after the really good good performances that he's put in so far. But as I said, next week we are at Spain, and yeah, looking forward to it. Just need to get that practice in and just go for it. But yeah, fair play to all the guys. It was a really, really decent race. But I've talked long enough. I'll let you guys get on and watch the end of the race. Let me know down below what your favourite circuit is. As Zandvoort is quickly becoming one of my top five, maybe even top three. But wherever you are in the world today, guys, hope you're good. Hope you take care, and I'll catch you in the next one.
Yeah, the car that got past Woodsey is catching me now. That was in DRS range.
Thank you.
see where it's run off. Yeah, you see the way. Oh, it's all on the racing line. I don't know what hard off the tail though. My tyres are about 42%. 42%. Ah, shit. What lap is the Renault pit? What lap did the Renault pit? Look at all this pitting. Matt Bricoli. Bricoli. Look what these 5 mile lap from each side. 7, I mean. Yeah. Oh, he's joined the traffic. Joined behind his teammate. And with the safety. I was about to defend him. I was defending him for like 9 laps. Uh-oh, this is a hard spot, probably got a safety car. Well, it's probably... No, not now. If you say we've got a safety car right now, it would be screwed. We just left 16 laps, though. So. Oh, yeah. We're going for a safety car now. Plus you will probably, you might jump to the sound driver. Both racing places.
connected.
Give me the OS. I know, I'm hoping the AR can give me the Shadow spawn. I've gone past him. We just spun. I swear, this is the African kitty. Wait, what would be good for us? Safety car?
No, in pit lane.
Got past them. Oh, it's got past. Oh, like that. Go now. Right. Oh, so that's not my ERN. Yeah, I'm pulling away from the lake. Like...
Well, they're not going to pass the flat. A 1:08 is the fastest flat. And I just did a 1:11.
Well, I'm not going for that.
Well, what was he doing with his tyres on? He did it earlier. I think he's on lap 6. The punter. Oh, go. Come on, purple.
Right, 2 cents down. 2,000, I mean. Yeah, I've got a 2 second gap to move, but I don't I've not been charged with the face paint. I'm on 21%. But yeah, I thought that Ferrari was just run off. I've got 8 more laps to do this time. Time to do some caring. Well, it hasn't gone off. Really wide. Ferrari side of the pit. Passenger side of the track. I think I've got a lot for it.
39. I hear hitting in the background. Well, that's giving me a freak out. That could just slim rumbled me down. Forty-seven now. Left that 56%. I'm feeling not gonna like blow up all. Okay. Last lap. I'm gonna say I'm gonna win because my Xbox turns off. Well, I've got 50% now, which is another math. All I would do is stay away from this turn now.